In today's video, you're going to learn about all of the new updates that are now available in Premiere Pro's Spring 2022 update. Let's get started. So if you haven't yet, be sure to go to the Adobe Creative Cloud desktop app and update to the latest version of Premiere Pro so you can see these updates. So the first biggest update is the new reimagined workspace for importing and creating your first project. So now when we click New Project in the new version of Premiere Pro, you'll see that you'll be able to create a project name, save the project in a location, and import your initial media in one window. And from here, I can browse all the media on my computer from my local hard drive. And then if I have any external devices like an SD card, you can import that footage just using this new import workspace. So let's say I want to import this stock video here that I got from ArtGrid. All of these clips, I can just click and lasso and select all of them, or I can individually click them using this checkbox. And it has this nice slider up here so you can make it bigger or smaller, or change it to the list format. So this didn't exist before. Of course, you'll still be able to use the old way of importing media once you're inside of Premiere Pro just by dragging and dropping a folder of assets into your project folder, for example. But this is just, I think, a better workspace. I mean, let me know what you think about this new import workflow. I think they've been workshopping this in beta for at least a year or even more. So I think they've done a pretty good job here. And one other thing that's really cool before we head inside of Premiere is there's a new bin over here on the import settings. So if you want to put this footage into a bin, you can name it anything from stock video to footage. So what this will do is create a new bin. Whoops. And you can have it automatically create a sequence for you with all of this footage included. And then I'll press create. So here you can see it automatically created the sequence for us with all of our footage. And from here, we can then chop it down and make our rough cut. You can see the bin was created. And you'll notice now in the workspace up at the top, you can go back to import at any time and then select edit to go into the edit workspace. And then there's a new export workspace, which I'll show you later on. But inside of the edit tab here, there's also at the very top, a new workspace tab. From this drop down, this is where you can edit your workspaces now. See how I have show workspace tabs checked? If I uncheck that, it goes away. But I can go ahead and turn that on to show my workspaces that I prefer. And from the drop down, you can go down to edit workspaces. I can choose which of the workspaces I want included. So here, if I don't want audio, I can bring this down and hit OK. And then it disappears, and you can then roll this in to make more space. There's also the quick export, which was already in the previous version, but now they've included more presets. So you can go down here and add more presets, YouTube 4K, for example. And so that way it'll appear in your presets if you want to automatically export something for YouTube in 4K. And the other update from the workspace is this maximize video icon. So if you need to go full screen, you can just click that icon. So the next update is an auto color feature that will auto correct your footage using Adobe Sensei technology. So in my timeline, we imported this log gamma footage, and I just want to quickly go in and correct it to bring back in more detail in the shadows and the highlights and make it more vibrant so it's not as flat. So I'm going to go to this shot here, and I'm going to select underneath Lumetri Color Basic Correction, the new Auto Color. And this will go in and just boost the exposure, create some more contrast depending on your shot. So you can see it's already looking a bit better, but we can also use this intensity slider to make more drastic changes. So it did a pretty good job, but the Adobe team did tell me that they recommend actually applying a Rec. 709 conversion LUT to convert your log into Rec. 709 before using the auto button. So I'm going to undo this and right click to create a new adjustment layer. And I'm going to drag this on top of my footage, just like this. And here on the adjustment layer, I'm going to go up to basic correction and then select input LUT. So this was shot on a red camera. So I'm going to select this and open that up. And you can see automatically it looks a lot better with this LUT. But from here, this is where you can go into each individual clip if you want to make further corrections, for example, this shot, and then select auto, and it will make further corrections on top of this clip. And we can maybe lower the intensity for this just slightly. So now you can see it just looks a lot better. And the reason why I'm doing it at the clip level is if I do it on the adjustment layer, it will just apply the auto corrections from that moment where your playhead is. So you need to do it on each clip level because each clip is a little bit different with different lighting. By the way, thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Kelsey and welcome back to Premiere Gal. On this channel, I post video editing tutorials and shorts just to help you become a better creator or video editor. And if this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe for more weekly content. And as a video creator and an editor myself, I struggle to find time to edit down my current content to share on TikTok, Instagram, as well as Facebook, because I know I have so much content out there, but I just don't have the time to repurpose it for all of the different aspect ratios and send it out. So I was wondering, is there a tool that can do this for me? And it turns out there is, where you don't have to pay anything out of pocket up front. And it's called JellySmack. JellySmack will come in, they will assign a bunch of video editors and marketers to you that will then repurpose your content. They'll do research, they will edit it down, and they'll use their AI technology that will automatically resize your video into the correct aspect ratio. So all you have to do is hand over your existing video content and JellySmack will handle the rest. You don't have to worry about editing anything. They will handle it for you so you can focus on the creative part, working on next week's video, next month's video, and not worry about trying to reach new people on the other platforms. And JellySmack is not new to this YouTube editing workspace. They're working with some of the biggest YouTubers to repurpose their content, like Mr. Beast, PewDiePie, Philip DeFranco, and Patrick Starr, just to name a few. So if you're a video creator and you want to learn more about what JellySmack can do for you, you can go to my link in my description or go to jellysmack.com/gal and let them know that I sent you. Again, that's jellysmack.com/gal. All right, let's go ahead and jump back into the rest of the Premiere Pro updates. So the next update is the export tab. If you've ever used Premiere Rush before, it's very similar to that. Everything is still here, just instead of a window opening up that you have to close, it's just built into the workspace. You don't have to close any windows. For example, if I wanted to go back to edit, I would just tap edit. And then if I need to export, just tap export. And I don't have to go up to file, export. It's just all built in here. So if you need to export your video file, again, you just go to media file and play around with the settings here. And before, you remember that it was like video, effects, captions in a horizontal layout. Well, now it's in a vertical layout. So you can go in and go deep into the settings here. For example, the captions, everything is here. And of course, you can upload to all of these different platforms here, from YouTube all the way down to FTP. For example, on YouTube, the one update that they made here, after you, of course, link your YouTube channel, you can add in all of this metadata, but it defaulted to private. So that way, when you upload directly from Premiere, it doesn't publish and go public right away, which is what I recommend. And I rarely use this because I tend to make content before and then I'll upload it later on. But it's really nice that they have this here, and you can add a custom thumbnail. So they pretty much have everything you need to do, so you don't even need to go to YouTube, which is quite useful. And the final update is that Frameio comes free with your Adobe Creative Cloud account. It's now built into both Premiere Pro and After Effects, and you get 2 users and 100 gigabytes free. And it will create a new plan for you. So if you already have a previous plan, I believe you need to figure out how to merge them. And I believe there'll be instructions. And if I find those instructions, I'll put them down below. But if you're new to Frameio, it's essentially a video review platform. So you can actually upload your sequence directly to Frameio and it will send a link to your reviewer. And the reviewer can leave comments, and those comments will appear as markers inside of the panel, and it will be time coded to your timeline, so you can just quickly make those edits. So Frameio will appear as a built-in panel that you can open up. You don't have to install an extension anymore. It'll already be there to log in, and you can go and upload your active sequence and send it off to your reviewer, and you don't have to pay for a separate plan, unless you need more space, I think. And the final update is that Adobe said that they're now making thousands of Adobe Stock video free. So if you go to Adobe Stock, you'll be able to browse more free stock video to download in your videos. And if you go to Essential Graphics and go to Adobe Stock, you can click on free now and you'll see that there's 16 pages of free Mogurts that you can download and save and use completely free with your Creative Cloud account. So here's some cool kinetic text, and you can hover to see a video preview, and these really cool lens transitions as well. If you want to download one of these, just click on this little cloud and arrow icon, and once they're installed, they will live here in your My Templates folder. So those are all the major updates in this spring release. What do you think of them? Do you think they're useful? Not so useful? Is there anything that you've been wanting in Premiere that hasn't come yet? Leave a comment below and I'd love to take a look. Also, if you want to learn more video editing tips or VFX tips in After Effects, you can just click right over here to watch some more videos on the channel. And you can click my head right over here to subscribe for more updates. That's all for today's video. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye. Whoop.